Hello dear students, how are you all? I know you must be doing great. Today I am back for the session 2 of our subject Social and Political Life, Chapter 1, Understanding Diversity. Before we start with our second session, let us recap what we learnt in session 1. In session 1, we learnt the meaning of the subject title, that is social and political life. Then in the chapter we learnt diversity in India, and we will continue with the topic Ladakh today. So let's start with the topic. Ladakh is in the eastern region of Jammu and Kashmir. Ladakh is basically a desert area. It's more on sandy area and receives less rain, as this area is of greater Himalayas. It is very cold. Many a times there is snow for months in this area, and there is less rainfall. As there is less rainfall, there is less agriculture. As there is less agriculture, people are more dependent on animal for food. They consume more of milk products and meat due to less of agriculture. This was about eating. Now if we think, what is the source of water for the people? The major source of drinking water in Ladakh is melting snow. In this region, a special type of sheep is found. It has a very soft and special fur, image is given for referral. So shawls are made from those fur, which are called Pashmina shawls. People in Ladakh make such shawls and sell them to the Kashmiri traders. This phenomena is going on since hundreds of years. So this is how you can see the geographical conditions that is on earth. There are more mountains, plains, valleys, rivers, seas, snowfall that affects the lives of people located in the areas or regions. What they eat, they wear, etc. This was about the geography of Ladakh. Let's learn about history of Ladakh. If we see history of Ladakh, it has been always trade route to Tibet. So since thousands of years, it has been an important place. Buddhism. Tibet is a center for Buddhism, but Buddhism reached Tibet via Ladakh. So due to this reason, Ladakh is also called Little Tibet. Around 400 years ago, Islam was introduced in Ladakh. Traders and merchants of Ladakh bought Islam in Ladakh. Apart from Islam, many other religions followers stay in Ladakh. Ladakh has rich oral tradition of songs and poems. Its national epic, the Kesar Saga, is performed by Muslim and Buddhist. Let us see Kerala. Kerala is located at the southern west corner of India. It has been an important place for traders. European traders travel by sea route to Kerala. Kerala was like a port for them. And the traders from Arabian countries visited Kerala too. So Kerala has been an important port for India. It was seen more of the geography of Kerala then. It has sea on one side and hills on the other side. The state has variety of spices and of good quality, like pepper, cloves, cardamom, etc. Images are given in slide for referral. Hence, Kerala was an attractive hub for traders. The first trader that came to Kerala were Jewish and Arab traders around 2000 years ago, almost when Jesus Christ was alive. Saint Thomas came to India and brought Christianity in India. He built the first church in India. Portuguese discovered sea route to India due to various traders visiting or sometimes settling in Kerala. There were various religion practiced in Kerala. Let me tell you an interesting fact about Kerala. As it is a coastal region, fishing is one of the occupation, and also fish are important part of diet for the people in Kerala. The fishing nets that are used in Kerala are more likely similar to Chinese fishing nets. This is quite weird but interesting. It's interesting thing to know, as there is vast distance between Kerala and China, but still they share many similarities. Apart from this, the vessel used in Kerala, known as Chinna Chatti, has got its name from Chin, that is China. Apart from fish, rice is also an essential part of food in Kerala. They also grow or cultivate rice in Kerala. So people in Kerala eat fish, rice, vegetables and many other things. Here we learnt about Kerala and Ladakh. Both are at very far distance. Ladakh is at one corner and Kerala is at the another corner. But their history is quite similar, as both the places were visited by traders from different and far away places. Our countries, the traders have influenced their culture a lot. With these two examples, we have learned that the history and geography of any place influences the culture of the place. Let's learn about a very interesting topic. Let's learn how our country was made out of one civilization. Around 500 years ago, Britishers came to Bengal. Always remember, Britishers came to Bengal, not our country. So what do you mean by not our country? It means our country did not existed. Then what existed? Okay, let me tell you a situation. Just imagine and try to feel. When Britishers came to Bengal, it was a state. They won Bengal. See, for instance, someone comes from Bengal and comes to me and tells me that some white people came to our place and fought with us, looted us, etc. First thing is that I won't understand what he is trying to tell me, because he must be speaking in Bengali and I don't understand Bengali language. I will think he is some crazy man and I have never heard Bengali language. This way, around 300 to 400 years ago. Now, for instance, I find a man who knows Bengali and my language too, and explains me what the Bengali man is saying all about, but still won't believe him, as I'm not aware of any such white skinned people. And even if I believe, I would think, how does it matter to me? You take care of your region. Why are you bothering me? It's very simple. This was the situation in our country when Britishers came to India. They saw this place is very prosperous, have a lot of resources, and is very rich. When Britishers came, they saw there are many states, and every state has different language. Every state has a different system. People are of every state have different culture, like different food, clothes, festivals, etc. So much of diversity. So, as languages were different, people in different states did not interact or were not connected like today. Today, we have internet. If anything happens to any corner of the country and is put on any social media like Twitter, Facebook, etc., we come to know the happenings. But in those days, it was not possible. So if anything happened in Bengal, no one would know how due to lack of communication. This was about different states. They also saw in one state too, there were different people, like there were four castes in one state. It was first time that Britishers noticed that there were people were divided in four castes. Even these four different caste people were not bothered with the happening with each other. Britishers further noticed that there were various types in the caste too. In Brahmins too, there were different types of Brahmins, and the same in Kshatriya and Shudras. Britishers took advantage of this thing. They captured one state, then they saw there were difference in two states. They made them fight each other, and then they captured them too. With many strategies, they captured the whole country. They were in peace. They never thought the country with so much of diversity would ever stand against them, oppose them. But it happened. It was surprising to see that people with so much of diversity stood together for one goal. Such thousands of people who stood together to fight against British rule, we call them freedom fighters. These freedom fighters reached people and made them realize how Britishers were looking our country, how Britishers were looting our country. They encouraged people of different state to stand together to form our own one country. By coming together, as this is our country, does not matter if we belong to different state or religion, but together we can make our country. They made people realize that we are one. So if we stand together and fight against Britishers, we'll get a chance to make our own one country. This way, a thought of our country came up. Before that, it was just different state, not a country. When the Britishers ruled India, people from different culture, religion and regions background came together to oppose them. Thousands of people worked together to protest British and even went to jails. British tried their best to keep us divided so they could crush our resistance. But the people showed them how they could be different and yet be united in the battle against British. One incident happened in Amritsar at Jallianwala Bagh. Many people had gathered to protest against British peacefully. It was non-violence protest. Britishers tried to overpower the people. In one such case that happened in Jallianwala, Amritsar, they opened fire on a large group of unarmed, peaceful people, killing many people and wounded even more. Hindus, Sikhs, Muslims, rich, poor had gathered to protest against the British. This is called Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Songs and symbols emerged during the freedom struggle to serve as a constant reminder of our country's rich tradition of respect for diversity. So, this was the end of the first chapter, and I hope you all have understood all the topics of the chapter. As I always tell you, do read the textbook, underline the hard words, write them 5 to 10 times so that you recite them well. Read the slides in the video, listen to the video carefully, look at the images in the slide for better understanding. So, see you in the third session of question and answer. Till then, bye. Take care.